I'm going to explain really quickly the difference between installing Kubernetes over Baremetal or virtual machine. And I'm going to start with an example that is using bookshelves instead of computers. So we are going to have three of them. Each one of them has a first book taking some room of the bookshelf that is the operating system. In the machine will be the amount of CPU and memory that the operating system itself is using. Okay, so we are going to install Kubernetes. So we are going to use one of the bookshelves like the master, and the other two just are going to have a small agent that is the one that makes them work. Okay, so now we are able to deploy or to put books in those that are workers. If we go to the machines, we will have the master functionality running in a computer over the operating system, and the workers with the agent over the operating system in each of the physical machines. If we go to the virtual machines example, it will be like in the bookshelf we put an additional book. This is the hypervisor that has a special capability, that is that now we can put small bookshelves inside this one. We are not gonna place books, but bookshelves inside this one. So it's one of these bookcases. It's gonna have its own operating system, and we are gonna install in one of them the functionality for the Kubernetes master, in the other two the Kubernetes workers, okay, the agents. So going back to the machines, we will have in the physical machine the operating system, the hypervisor, and this hypervisor is allowing us to have these virtual machines. Each one of them will have the operating system, and we are going to install one of them as master and the other two in this example as workers. Okay, so as advantages and disadvantages of using these virtual machines. The first thing is that now we have multiple operating systems, so we are using resources of the physical machine just for running operating systems. This is making a less efficient usage of the resources that we have. We have this additional layer, this hypervisor, the building of the virtual machines. We have to manage all that, we have to maintain that, we have to apply patches, updates, we have to go through that layer when running troubleshooting, so it's an additional complexity. But advantages are pretty powerful. Now we can create virtual machines on demand. We don't have to physically buy a machine, go to the lab, place the cabling, place the power. No, we just click and create a virtual machine, so we can increase and decrease the size of the cluster. The cluster is the Kubernetes master and the workers. We can increase and decrease the size of the cluster, and we can even place multiple clusters in parallel using the same physical resources. Okay, and the second advantage is related to that one. We can put our users in separate clusters because we are creating those resources virtually. It is not an effort for us to create an additional cluster. Okay, so there is one more thing that people is commonly wrong about, that is, as we are placing Kubernetes over virtual machines, the workloads, the containers, are not gonna be as powerful as they were before when running over Baremetal. That's not true. That's why we have EPA. Enhanced Platform Awareness makes that possible. It makes that the virtual machines are able to perform as if they were physical machines. So placing the Kubernetes over a virtual machine that is using EPA, it's gonna perform as well as a Kubernetes directly over a Baremetal. I hope that although it was quick, it was clear. And as always, please feel free to contact me for further explanation, and thanks for watching.